Welcome back. Well, the immigration debate has been reignited this week due to the New South Wales opposition leader Luke Foley describing the exodus of many long-term residents from the Sydney suburb of Fairfield as white flight. He was noting that as they were leaving, the bulk of the 12,000 Syrian and Iraqi refugees entering Australia were ending up in that one suburb. So, is the influx of migrants being matched with increased services, jobs and infrastructure? We took to the streets of Fairfield to see what the locals had to say.
I mean, you go back a few years and this has changed. I admit it, yeah. Yeah, it's, we need more roads, more public transport, and more living areas. You know, I mean, we're getting people through the door at 100 miles an hour now. So, you know, we're falling behind. That's what I'm saying.
Really multicultural in Fairfield. Yeah.
Because it's part of my community, so I could speak my language as well.
Yeah, very busy because many people here, many groups about Syrian, Iraqi, like mix, you know.
Yes, too many people. Since I came to Australia, this has changed so much. It wasn't better before. It was better before. Too busy. The road is so busy. The schools the same.
Yeah, interesting observations, aren't they? And, of course, coming from people who are living there. So for today's agenda, I'm joined by social researcher Ashley Pell from McCrindle and the Mayor of Fairfield, Frank Carboni. Good morning and welcome to you both.
Good morning, George.
Mayor, if I could begin with you, what is your take on Mr Foley's use of the term white flight? Is it accurate? Is it offensive?
Well, I think it's an unfortunate term, but there's no doubt that he's raised some important issues. The issues about putting 7,000 people in one particular locality, refugees who have come, does raise a lot of challenges for the local community. Our community has always welcomed refugees. It's nothing new to Fairfield. Fairfield has always opened up its homes to people, has always welcomed them, and they've always been resettled. But obviously, when you put 7,000 people in one particular location, it does raise some issues. I think the government needs to stop counting houses and counting people. That's a really important fact, because I think at the end of the day, we need to look after people's lifestyles.
That's a very good point. Just on that, though, are these people coming in at the expense of long-term residents leaving? Are they leaving as a result? Can you attribute it to that?
Well, as I said, Fairfield has always resettled refugees. Even since the early days from across the globe, there's always been people coming in and there's always been people leaving. People leave for different reasons. But obviously, through the 7,000 refugees that have been established, that does have an impact on the community. It does have a strain on resources, and that does force community people to move out for a variety of reasons. Some people move out it might be a financial or a family reason, but the congestion, there's no doubt that the congestion and the 7,000 people that have moved in does raise challenges for our community.
Ashley, give us the demographics of this area. A snapshot, if you like.
Well, in Fairfield, we know from the latest census data that 7 in 10 residents are born overseas. And if we compare that to the national average, it's just 33% of Australians are born overseas, so quite higher in Fairfield. And we also know in Fairfield that 3 in 4 households speak a language other than English at home, compared to 1 in 5 households nationally. So very culturally diverse in terms of the statistics, as well as the real-life stories we saw there before.
And is that a phenomenon that's being played out in cities around the country? Are there other suburbs that you would say are a similar phenomenon to Fairfield?
Yeah, that's right. So in Fairfield, as we said before, 70% of residents are born overseas. Down in Clayton, in Victoria, there was another suburb there that had 75% of residents born overseas, so 7 in 10 for both those two suburbs in Sydney and Melbourne. Up north in Queensland, we looked at Sunnybank and it showed that 68.7% of residents there were born overseas. Over in WA, the suburb of Queen's Park, there was 65% of residents there born overseas. And then in Adelaide, in the city of Adelaide as a suburb itself, 61% of residents born overseas. And it's really interesting when you think about some of the changes we have seen, even some of the changes in the census data. We know that 1 in 5 of Australia's migrants has arrived in Australia since 2012. So quite accelerated over the last 6 years, and 86% of those are settling in our capital city. So definitely the capitals, especially in Sydney and Melbourne, is really fronting a lot of that migration population growth.
Well, the complexion is changing, isn't it?
That's
and
right.
It's changing quickly. Mm. We are a country just so rich in diversity and built on multiculturalism, and most of us love it. I'm wondering, though, Frank, how this is bearing out in your particular suburb and your particular council area. Schools, for example, how are they coping with the fact that the majority of students now would be from non-English-speaking families? How does that affect teachers?
Well, obviously, it impacts the whole community. There's only so many schools in so many places, and education is extremely important to the resettlement refugees. Refugees are quite different to skilled migrants. Skilled migrants come and they have jobs, so it's important that we have a really good education system to be able to transition both the children and the adults so they can make a quicker contribution, so they can take the opportunity this nation has given them and so they can give back by getting jobs and making a contribution not only to the city but to the nation. And Fairfield has such a wonderful story to tell. The Fairfield community has done the heavy lifting for this nation for many generations. It's been a revolving doors of migrants. Migrants are welcome to our city, but 7,000 people in one spot is like creating a new suburb, and that does raise challenges for infrastructure.
And that makes a whole lot of sense, doesn't it, Ashley? I mean, infrastructure has to keep up with this intake of migrants.
Oh, definitely, and that's certainly what we've seen in Australia. Our population growth has been kind of almost unprecedented, and it's grown record-breaking growth almost, and it was unplanned for. We saw some Australian Bureau of Statistics projections that were really quite outdated in 1998. We kind of already hit that population milestone nationally that they projected we hit in 2050. So it is certainly about the planning, and as Frank was saying, migration certainly has a lot of benefits, economic and social, but we really need to make sure that infrastructure and planning keeps up with that population growth. Otherwise, you know, we get frustrated citizens and congestion, and as I said, you ask any Sydney and Melbourneites and they'll tell you about that. So.
In closing, Frank, I think that was the point Luke Foley was trying to make, and yet he was absolutely pilloried by his party. He was forced to apologise. It must frustrate you immensely that when these sort of topics are brought up, they get sidelined by politics when you want to see action. What would be your message to our politicians?
Well, we've been talking for this for quite a long time. We need to start talking about how we resolve these issues, how we give people jobs, how we make sure that people's quality of life is maintained. My message is I'd love to welcome the Immigration Minister. We took 7,000 of the 12,000 humanitarian intake for the whole nation. That is a substantial intake, and I would love for the Minister to come out to Fairfield so we can have a discussion about utilising the strengths of our city, the diversity of our city, and utilising how we can actually work together in making that an important part of our nation, of taking all the great things that diversity brings and bringing a benefit not just to our city but to the nation. But we need to work together. We need to leave the politics aside, put people at the forefront of it all, come together. I would love to see the opportunities of building a multicultural hub for our city, leveraging off the new airport, making Prairiewood and Fairfield a regional centre where we can become the gateway for tourism for a new airport that's been created. A lot's been talked about, the benefits and the investment in Western Sydney, but it's important to understand, again, you need more resources to resettle refugees. Refugees need funding for education, for health, the infrastructure needs to be there, and I think, again, our community in Fairfield should be congratulated for the way that they've taken them in, but I think they also need to be, it needs to be understood that they should not be impacted. Existing communities should not be impacted for taking in 7,000 new residents. We welcome them. But the Immigration Minister and the Federal Government has a responsibility to the community and to the people to come and visit Fairfield, given that we've done such heavy lifting.
Well, I hope they are answering your calls, because that's very well said, and no one could argue with that. Frank, thank you so much. Ashley, great to get your insight as well. It is a very relevant topic, Carl.
Right across the country, Georgie. Yeah. The Mayor making a lot of...